You can see how it works just now. We put the basket on its side, we fix the envelope to it, we take the fan and we blow him up as much as possible. When it's half inflated, I switch the burner on and I heat the cold air inside the balloon up. So it will become full size, and of course when it's warm enough, it will get upright. So the basket will be ready to enter as it is now, in this position. But the bubble is about 22 meters high and 18 meters across, so it's quite big. Lucky us, no wind here on the ground. But if there would be a breeze or something coming up, that thing would like to go on its own. And I'm alone in it, so very light. And I don't want to go without you, so it's better if you come close and put some weight on the basket here to hold me down. Yeah, don't run away. Just get close and one by one climb into the basket. Here's the steppy here in the front. You can hold on to this here at the top. Don't step on here, just swing your leg elegantly over this and in here. So you've made it, you're inside. What goes up must come down. You know that is the thing in aviation. Landing is an issue. And we have two versions of landings which we offer. First the good and the bad ones. And secondly, of course, the slow and the fast. Now, we call them slow and fast landings. Slow landings is the one which we expect today. That will be when the wind on the ground is under 10 kilometers per hour. Here we go. Look at the clouds on the over the water. It's pitch dark, you can just make him out there, but it's visible, but yeah. it's just no contrast. There's clouds over Table Mountain, so they have no sun in Cape Town. Pal Mountain is granite, everything else is sandstone. I mean, Pal Rock is the rest of a volcano, while everything else is raised seabed. Yeah. From Pal Rock, underground to Paardeberg, this is also granite. This used to be the base of a 15 kilometer high mountain. Was nearly double the height of Mount Everest. And that's granite, while everything is sandstone. So that's a big difference. Very few people know that. Yeah, there's the west coast. You can see the west coast here, very clear today. Very far, 100 k. Yeah. There are the Cedarbergs in the distance. The far mountains is the Cedarberg Mountains already.
And this one here in front?
That is Ribbeck Castell.
How much of your gas will you normally use on a flight like this?
How much?
How much?
I mean, about 120 liters.
You've got...
yeah.
How much have you got?
I got about 180
right.
with me. Yeah, 120 right. We will use for the flight. These are all plums. This is the biggest plum orchard in the southern hemisphere here. Yeah. They bought the land from the neighboring farmers. They bought the water rights. They put the dam on the hill, and then they did the windbreaks, and everything was done like an investment. It's not like a normal farming thing. This is an investment farm.
So all those ridges of trees are windbreaks?
Yeah. Yeah, because when the plums are ripe and you get strong winds, that would be it.
Way down, so you're looking right up at the balloon and us looking down. And it would fall off, no?
So we are really lucky because we are nearly 1,000 meters and that steep slope, which should never be allowed. I'm against that because that erosion was caused because the guys tried to farm on the slopes. It should never be allowed to build a house on top of a ridge. That was forbidden. In the old days it was forbidden. This is brand new, this house, only about 5 years or so. And the farmers went up these mountains, but it's actually very bad because it destroyed. Unfortunately, this area, the indigenous vegetation, what you still see there, is called a Rhenosterfeld. And this type of Rhenosterfeld from this area, when you look around you, 20 km, is completely destroyed, except for 2% of the original vegetation. Because of bad farming practice, you know. There is absolutely no control what farmers do on their land. Nobody controls that, nobody. So anything goes. You can kill what you want, you can plant what you want, you can destroy what you want. Because these farmers still think they are the kings. This belongs to them, you know. They don't live in a country or in the world, they live on their planet. These farms are still farmed, you know, they didn't go up all the way. There are some old fields there on the slope, you see there. They try to farm, but it's not worth it. It's far too steep. You don't make any money. I mean, to get the tractor up there, it's dangerous. You don't get any harvest. I mean, you don't need it.
Getting bigger and bigger.
Yeah. See the hills now? Suddenly this is a hill.
Surely enough, she can't see it.
Will this balloon just slowly start to
It will fall on us. If I don't heat now, it will fall. significant.